increasing the reservation or bringing new reservation, yes or no? That is going, okay? ये हो रहा है बस सोसाइटी में. कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट पास्ड रिजर्वेशन बिल और कोटा बिल फॉर प्राइवेट सेक्टर. यस, दैट वाज़ द फर्स्ट न्यूज. सेकंड न्यूज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू बांग्लादेश, एंटी कोटा राइट्स. यस, एंड थर्ड, fake certificates, okay? Again, this particular issue is related to a reservation. Yes, okay? So we will be discussing that particular issue of reservation in detail, okay? What are the provisions, what are the judgments, why it is necessary, okay? And what are the loopholes, okay? Then we will discuss that what is the difference between affirmative actions and reservation. Okay, quota system and affirmative action. What is the difference? Okay, along with this, we will also discuss caste system. Okay, why? Okay, what is the caste system and what is the need to give a reservation or affirmative action? Okay, so first, let's discuss about caste. What is caste? Because it is directly linked with reservation. Okay, what is caste? Huh? Varna system is not the caste system. Yes? Varna system is not the caste system. Okay. But what is caste system? Anyone? Not system of discrimination. System of social hierarchy. Okay? Which is discriminatory towards certain section of the society. Not system of discrimination. It is a particular social system, okay, where various castes are hierarchically arranged and certain functions are assigned to certain sections. Yes? Yet, okay, this particular system became discriminatory towards certain sections of the society because with the time, more and more liabilities are attached to the particular section and more privileges are given to certain section. Yes? And how it evolved? So it evolved from Varna system, okay? That was mentioned in the 10th mandal of Rig Veda. Yes? Okay? So this is caste system. So write down certain things about Varna system on the one hand, caste system on the other hand. Look, any of the current affairs we will discuss in this manner, okay? I'm not going to teach something like these are the facts and mug it up, okay? We will pick one or two topics from that particular week and we will discuss, okay, all the aspect of that particular topic in detail, okay? Because this particular topic is from your society section, okay? So we are combining that society section to polity section. Yes or no? Okay. So caste system, Varna system. Varna system. Okay. Varna system. Mentioned in Purush Sukta. Purush Sukta. Purush Sukta hymn of Rig Veda. Rig Veda. Okay. But it never talks about untouchables and outcast. Never talks about untouchables and outcast. Four Varnas were there. Four Varnas kon kon se the? Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. Only four Varnas. but it never talks about untouchables. Never talks about untouchables and outcast. What is the purpose of Varna system? Very good. Okay, social division of labor. First point, social division of labor. For any society, okay, certain works are divided. Okay, for social division of labor. Okay, that social division was by birth or by qualities, capabilities? By capabilities. इसीलिए ये तो कास्ट आया ना. हम सिर्फ वर्णा सिस्टम का अभी देख रहे हैं. ओके, सो व्हाट वाज़ द पर्पस? डिवीजन ऑफ लेबर. ओके, सेकंड, कोहेजन बिटवीन द डिफरेंट सेगमेंट्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी. कोहेजन एंड कॉपरेशन. Okay, next, that division was based on capabilities or abilities rather than by birth. Okay, there are certain theories which are attached with this particular concept of Varna system, like that we mentioned that Purush Sukta hymn of Rigved, that is divine origin theory. What is divine origin theory? Because according to Rigved, okay, one Purush, okay, was there, and from his brain Brahmanas are born. Yes, from his shoulders and biceps, okay, Kshatriyas are born. Yes, so in this manner, so it is a divine origin theory. Okay, second, guna theory, because certain people are saying that this division is based upon guna. Okay, whatever you have quality or whatever you have ability, according to that ability certain tasks are assigned or certain varna is assigned to you. Okay, one is racial theory, because varna means color. Okay, so one more theory is racial theory. Okay, now caste system. This is enough for Varna system. Okay, what happened with this system with the time? What happened? It became, okay, discriminatory. Why? Because from now onwards or with the time, those tasks are assigned by birth. Okay, not on the basis of their capabilities, not on the basis of their abilities. Yes or no? Okay, the offsprings of Brahmins became Brahmins, offsprings of Kshatriya became Kshatriya. Okay, in this manner, so that Varna system became caste system. Okay, so according to this particular notion, can we say that four Varnas were there, so now there are only four castes? No? Why? Because of specialization of work. Okay? Many castes are born. Kyunki ek to kaam hota nahi hai na. There is not only a single work in the society. So many tasks are there. Okay? And on the basis of those tasks, okay, what happened? Innumerable of castes were born. Okay, write down caste system. is the system of social stratification, which involves hierarchically arranged closed endogamous strata, what is endogamy? Two terms, endogamy and exogamy. What is endogamy? Maybe within your own caste. And exogamy? Intercaste. Okay. So closed endogamy strata, where membership is ascriptive. Comma. Contact is restricted. And mobility is theoretically impossible. Theoretically impossible. Okay. System of social stratification. What is a stratification? Hierarchically arranged. First thing. Second, stratification. What is stratification means? Yes. No. Social stratification means different people are arranged in hierarchical order and they are having unequal access to resources and other opportunities. Unequal access. That is why inequality, okay, was there in the caste system and it is still present. Why? Because of that stratification. There is no problem with that hierarchical arrangement of any system. But that stratification is bringing inequality of opportunity. Okay, next thing is closed endogamous. What is closed endogamous? We have discussed. After that, membership is ascriptive. What is ascriptive? Based on birth. Okay, based on birth. Something which is achieved. Okay, whatever you are doing right now, okay, you will be an IAS officer. So this is your achieved thing. And something is ascriptive in nature, which means in the family that you are born. Okay, that is your ascriptive status. Aapke piche jo surname laga hua hai, which is ascriptive in nature, not achieved. Got the idea? Ye definition yaad honi chahiye, rat jaani chahiye. Ascriptive. Contact is restricted. Clear, right? Okay. That is untouchability. And mobility is theoretically impossible. Why mobility is theoretically impossible? Brahmin will remain Brahmin throughout his life. Yes? Shudra will remain Shudra throughout his life. Okay? His status will not change. Okay? In whatever manner. Yes or no? Okay? He will remain, okay, in that particular caste only, irrespective of his economic status, educational status, or political status. Yes, this is caste system. Okay, in Varna system, mobility was possible. Okay, in Varna system, if you want, you can write. In Varna system, mobility was possible. But in caste system, mobility is not possible. Okay. In Varna system, that status can be achieved. But here, that status is ascriptive. You got the idea? What is caste system? Okay, to dismantle this particular caste system. Why? Because it is rigid in nature. Okay, we have discussed why it is rigid. Because membership is ascriptive and mobility is impossible. Okay, moreover, it is endogamous in nature and contact is restricted means it will perpetuate untouchability as well, because concept of pollution and purity is also attached with certain tasks. Okay, like certain tasks are considered as impure, like sweeping. Yes. Okay, Next point. Concept of purity and pollution is also attached. Concept of pollution and purity is also attached with this system. Along with occupational division of labor. Occupational division of labor. Yes. So basically, caste system became system of discrimination, because certain caste who are in the higher level of hierarchy were provided privileges, and those who are at the lower ranks attached to certain disabilities. Okay. And there is one ideal in our constitution, that is equality. Yes. Okay. And to achieve that equality, this system needs to be dismantled. Yes. That privileges should be disability. Yes or no? For that, affirmative actions, okay, were envisaged in our constitution. Okay. Yes. Affirmative action. Heading. Affirmative action. Write down. A set of anti-discriminatory measures intended to provide access to preferred position in the society of members of group who would otherwise excluded. Yes, who would otherwise exclude it? This is affirmative action. Okay. Give certain example of affirmative action. Reservation. More.
Reservation to hai. Apart from reservation, what are... Abhe, nahi yaar.
What are other examples? Reservation is okay. Apart from that.
Like, which one?
Special status to whom?
We are discussing
certain groups or certain section of the society. Okay, are provided certain special privileges. Like?
Huh? Then, nahi yaar. Wo thodi affirmative action.
What are other things? I mean, special policies and programs. Special policies and programs.
Example?
ICDS for women and children. Yes, this is also one form of affirmative action. Okay. Free passes in DTC buses for women.
It is also one form of affirmative action.
Seats in metro. Separate coaches.
ओके मोर हाँ बहुत सारे ऐसे प्रोग्राम ओके दीज ऑल आर कंसीडर्ड एज अफर्मेटिव एक्शन ओके एंड रिजर्वेशन इज वन ऑफ द अफर्मेटिव एक्शन ओके दैट कोटा सिस्टम और रिजर्वेशन इज वन ऑफ द अफर्मेटिव एक्शन ओके रिजर्वेशन इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ अफर्मेटिव एक्शन राइट डाउन रिजर्वेशन इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ अफर्मेटिव एक्शन where percentage of seats are reserved for people belonging to socially and educationally backward classes who are inadequately represented in educational institution, government jobs, parliament or state legislatures. Okay, you got the idea? What is reservation? Okay, now how it evolved in India? Evolution of reservation. Okay, so one is Article 16. Article 15 clause 1 is saying that no citizen shall be discriminated. Write down. Shall be discriminated on the basis of race, religion, caste, sex, and place of birth. Similarly, no citizen shall be discriminated on the basis of race, religion, caste, sex, place of birth in the matter of public employment. This is Article 16, Clause 1 and 16, Clause 2. Write down fast. हो गया यस ओके सो नो सिटीजन कैन बी डिस्क्रिमिनेटेड ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रेस रिलीजन कास्ट सेक्स प्लेस ऑफ बर्थ ओके दैट इज आर्टिकल 15 नो सिटीजन कैन बी डिस्क्रिमिनेटेड ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रेस रिलीजन कास्ट सेक्स प्लेस ऑफ बर्थ यहां पे दो और चीज एक्स्ट्रा है दैट इज डिसेंट एंड residence. Two more criteria are extra in 16 clause 1, 16 clause 2. Okay, so only on the basis of these, matlab, what is the meaning of these two articles? Only on the basis of means you can be discriminated on other grounds. What are other grounds? Age, educational criteria, socioeconomic backwardness, yes, educational backwardness, these can be the criteria. Like in UPSC, you cannot apply after 32 years of age. So age is the criteria in discrimination. Yes? Okay. So after that, what happened? Ye likh liya sabne? After that, there is one more article in Constitution. That is
DPSP. And in DPSP,
there is one provision.
Then state shall make, write down, state shall make special provision for, state shall make special provision for, special provision for advancement of socially and educationally backward classes. 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 That is SC and ST. That is ST and SC. Okay. By following this mandate, this particular mandate, okay, Tamil Nadu government in 1950, okay, started their reservation policy.
Okay, because of their reservation policy, one student named Champakam Dorai Rajan, okay, Champakam Dorai Rajan did not get admitted in medical college, okay,
because of that reservation policy, because he was from general category, okay, he was having good marks, but still he was unable to make in that particular list. Okay, he reached to the Supreme Court. He reached Supreme Court. Write down Champakam Dorai Rajan case. Champakam Dorai Rajan case. He reached Supreme Court. Now, what Supreme Court said? Supreme Court said fundamental rights will prevail over DPSP. Write down fundamental rights will prevail over DPSP. Okay, if fundamental rights will prevail over DPSP, means reservation policy cannot be implemented. Yes or no? Means reservation policy cannot be implemented. That is reservation. Reservation is violating the right to equality. Reservation is violating the right to equality. Yes or no? So that particular policy of Tamil Nadu government was struck down by Supreme Court. Now, what happened? Parliament is parliament. First Constitutional Amendment Act 1951 was
passed, which added
Article 15 Clause 4 in the Constitution. Which added Article 15 Clause 4, yes?
अभी हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, okay. अभी जो हो रहा है वही तो हम कर रहे हैं ना डिस्कस, बीच में क्वेश्चन मत पूछो, अभी हो जाएगा सारा क्लियर, ओके? एट लास्ट आपका पूरा इस क्लास के बाद में रिजर्वेशन से रिलेटेड पूरे कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर हो जाएंगे, ठीक है?
फर्स्ट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट दैट एडेड आर्टिकल 15 क्लोज 4 इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. Which specifically mentioned that nothing in this article.
What is article?
That article. Nothing in this
article. This article. Okay. Nothing in this article shall prevent state from making any special provision.
State from making any special provision.
Any special provision for women and children. For women and children. No.
Any special provision for the advancement of, for the advancement of socially and educationally backward classes. Socially and educationally backward classes. For the advancement of socially and educationally backward classes, that is SC and
ST, this one, that is ST and SC.
Okay, so basically parliament specified that what is socially and educationally backward classes, SC and ST only. Okay, so now it is written in the constitution, इट इज रिटन इन द
सामने बैठ के बात मत करो
इट इज रिटन इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन नाउ इट इज स्पेसिफिकली ओके सेइंग दैट नथिंग इन दिस आर्टिकल कैन प्रिवेंट द स्टेट फ्रॉम मेकिंग एनी स्पेशल प्रोविजन ओके सो via article 15 clause 4 state governments and central governments started their reservation policy okay via article 15 clause 4 okay write down hence article 15 clause 4 became article 15 clause 4 became the foundation stone for reservation and affirmative policy or affirmative actions of the government okay any doubt till now yes Yes, reservation is discriminatory according to some scholars. That is why we are understanding this topic in this much detail. Okay, that what happened. Okay, what was the scenario? That is caste system. That was discriminatory in nature. Okay, to end those discrimination, those privileges, those disabilities. Okay, government of India started reservation policy. Why they started? Because certain sections of the society were not adequately represented in educational institution. We have written that particular thing that in educational institution, in government jobs and in parliament. Because of that, government of India started reservation policy. पॉजिटिव लिख लो सेम ही बात है वो सेम ही तो है पॉजिटिव डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंटी डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी बात वही है पॉजिटिव डिस्क्रिमिनेशन विल आल्सो लीड्स टू द इक्वालिटी इन द सोसाइटी एंटी डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी मेजर्स विल आल्सो लीड्स टू द इक्वालिटी इन द सोसाइटी यू कैन राइट व्हाट यू वांट देयर इज नो इशू विद दैट पर्टिकुलर वर्ड ओके नेक्स्ट सो आर्टिकल 16 clause 4 became what found 15 clause 4 became foundation stone for reservation policy in India okay first we will discuss reservation in educational institution okay after that we will discuss reservation in and after that we will discuss reservation in parliament okay because article 15 clause 4 is more related to the reservation in educational institution okay after that article 15 clause 4 government implemented this aap chale jao bahar aapko nahi baithna hai class mein maine kya kaha mujhse bolo na disturb ho rahe hain yahan pe 15 clause 4 okay to kya cheez hai yahan pe 15 clause 4 7.5% reservation for ST and 15% reservation for SC in government educational institution was implemented. Okay. You got the idea after this particular act 15 clause 4. Now, the question arised that can government of India implement the same reservation policy in private educational institution? Yes or no? Yes? No? That was the confusion. Okay, government of India implemented that particular policy in all the institution. Government, private, whether aided by government or not, they implemented that particular policy in all the institution. Yes? Now, private educational institutions reached to the Supreme Court. What they said? that this particular policy is violating our right to business, right to profession. You got the idea? Yes?
Write down. Next.
PA Inamdar case. After this, 15 clause 4, what is? PA Inamdar case.
PA Inamdar case. Supreme Court held that. Write down fast. We have limited time, okay? Supreme Court held that reservation cannot be enforced in the private
unaided educational institution. Private unaided. Okay? Means reservation policy of government cannot extend.
Okay, in the private educational institution. Now it is clear to the government that we cannot implement that particular policy in private educational institution. Again, Parliament reacted. 93rd
Constitutional Amendment Act 2005, and they added 15 clause
5. Write down fast.
And they nullified PA Inamdar judgment. That is, from now onwards, reservation policy of the government can be extended up to in the private educational institution as well, right now.
They nullified PA Inamdar judgment, and
that is, reservation policy can be implemented in the private educational institution as well. That, okay? Except minority educational institution.
Okay, so that reservation, that quota policy is applicable to all the private educational institution, all the government educational institution, except minority educational institution.
Yes, notes will be available, okay, for today's class. Aapko bahut sara printed material mil jayega. Bahut sara to nahi hai, bahut chote chote points. Okay? You will get all the notes. You got the idea? Yes? Okay. After Mandal Commission case, you know
that Mandal Commission case?
Mandal Commission case or Indira Sahani case? Indira Sahani case? What was the case? In that particular case, 27%
reservation for OBC was also recognized and it became constitutional. Yes? This after Indira Sahani case or Mandal Commission case, 27% reservation for OBC also recognized. Okay? So in educational institution, 7.5% for ST and 15% for SC and 27% for OBC implemented in educational institution as well. Okay, write down. Central Educational Institution, Reservation in Admission Act. Central Educational Institution, Reservation in Admission Act 2005. And that implemented 27% reservation
in educational institution for OBC as well. Okay. That affirmative action is expanding. Yes. Now it is becoming discriminatory. That positive discrimination now, okay, turning into discrimination as well. Okay. Because according to Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar himself, that reservation should be limited to the minority seats only. And now it is that minority seats are becoming the majority seats. okay, because majority of the seats are reserved for, okay, certain category. Yes or no? Okay, we will be writing those quotes as well. Okay, so OBC reservation was extended 27% in educational institution. Now again, case was filed in the Supreme Court. Supreme Court in Ashok Kumar Thakur case. Supreme Court in Ashok Kumar Thakur case. Ashok Kumar Thakur case. What Supreme Court said? Supreme Court upheld the validity of Article 15 Clause 5.
Article 15 Clause 5
and this particular act, Central Educational Institution Act,
Reservation in Admission Act,
which means OBC reservation in educational institution became constitutional
after Ajay Kumar Thakur case. Yes.
So this is all about reservation in educational institution. Okay. Any doubt? Any doubt?
Kuch doubt hai kya? Batao, batao. Puchho. होगा ही सही ना. देखते हैं इसको भी, देखते हैं इतना क्लियर हुआ अभी. मेरा कुछ पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू नहीं है क्योंकि मैं ऑनलाइन भी हूं ना. ठीक है, राइट डाउन. नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल 16. आर्टिकल 16 नाउ रिजर्वेशन इन जॉब्स. ओके,
so article 16 clause 1 clause 2 we have already discussed that. Okay, no citizen shall be discriminated only on the basis of race, religion, caste, sex, place of birth, residence and descent. Okay, only on these basis no citizen can be discriminated. Okay, after that write down article 16 clause 4.
Article 16 clause 4, that is nothing in this article shall prevent the state,
nothing in this article shall prevent the state from making any special provision.
Nothing in this article shall prevent the state from making. We don't have much time. Okay,
we have only 2 hours. Increase your speed.
ओके,
आज की क्लास में तो हम सिर्फ एक ही टॉपिक डिस्कस कर पाएंगे. जो यूसीसी जो मैंने बोला था वो हो ही नहीं पाएगा फिर ऐसे, है ना. हमें यूसीसी भी न्यूज में था अभी. ओके, लास्ट वीक सुप्रीम कोर्ट गेव, क्या हुआ लास्ट वीक, सुप्रीम कोर्ट गेव वन जजमेंट दैट मुस्लिम वुमेन्स आर एंटाइटल्ड टू दैट मेंटेनेंस. ओके, सो दैट यूसीसी वॉज अगेन इन द न्यूज and that can be asked. वो भी हमें discuss करना है, तो जल्दी लिखो थोड़ा सा. Nothing in this article shall prevent state from making any special provision for the reservation. For reservation in the matter of appointment. In the matter of appointment. In favor of any backward class. In the matter of appointment for any backward class. Okay, 16 clause 4. So why are using this particular article? Government implemented
again
7.5% reservation for ST, 15% reservation for
SC. Okay,
the real problem regarding a reservation, it starts after that Mandal Commission report. Okay, till date there was no such problem. The real politicization of that reservation issue started after Mandal Commission report. Okay, what was Mandal Commission was second backward class commission. Second backward class commission, and which recommended 27% reservation for OBC. Why this particular issue increased or led to politicization of reservation or politicization of caste? Yes, everyone started seeking for the reservation. Till now, we have discussed that reservation was given to socially and educationally backward class, that is ST and SC only. Okay, now from OBC, OBC means other backward class. Now every caste are saying that we are OBC. Even Marathas are saying we are OBCs. Jats are saying we are OBCs. Patels in Gujarat are saying we are OBC. Okay, so even forward class, Kshatriya class, are also started demanding reservation under OBC. Okay, and because of that, politicization of caste was started. That is, politicization of that reservation issue was started. And now it reached up to its maximum limit. That is, now government are passing reservation bill for private sector as well. Yesterday, one guy from Uttar Pradesh, okay, one MP, he introduced private member bill, okay, to seek reservation in private sector as well. Okay, something like Ravan type ka naam hai uska kuch. Okay, he introduced that bill. Yes? Private member bill. Nowhere in the constitution it is mentioned. We have already discussed that in Article 16. Look, Article 16 is related to only public sector employment. Okay, government can. अबे यार बात क्यों कर रहे हो? क्या हुआ? कुछ doubt है क्या? मतलब disturb होता है ना, आपकी वजह से सब लोग disturb हो रहे हैं. या तो चले जाओ उठ के, या फिर यहीं बैठना हो तो ढंग से बैठो. Government can only bring reservation in public employment. Okay? Only public employment, not in private sector employment. Okay? Second thing, it is only available for full-time job, not contractual job. जो संविदा वाली जो vacancy आती है ना, contractual, संविदा, guest faculty, it is not applicable for that also. It is only available for full-time employment, public employment, not for private sector employment. Still they are bringing. Okay? Ab ye kahan se la rahe hain, pata nahin. You got the idea? Yes, but it will affect fundamental right. Yes. Yeah? That is why we are discussing right now. That is why that reservation quota, reservation in private sector bill was also introduced by Haryana government. That was rejected by Chandigarh High Court. Okay, the same Karnataka reservation bill will also be rejected by the Supreme Court or High Court in future. Okay, basically politicization means what is happening? When any political party or when any politician is failing, okay, in the promises that he made during his election campaign, okay, now they all are resorting to the increasing the reservation or bringing new reservation. Yes or no? That is going. Okay, ye ho raha hai bas society mein. Like in Bihar, they conducted caste census and they increased reservation. Why? Because Bihar government is failed, okay, in its mandate. Okay, they failed to provide jobs for their youth. Okay, so they increased the reservation. Basically, they diverted the entire debate of unemployment towards the reservation. Yes or no? This is going on. Everyone is diverting that unemployment related issue towards the reservation. Okay, now nobody is going to ask that what is unemployment rate? Okay, how much employment that government has generated? Yes or no? Now everyone is talking about reservation in private sector. Yes or no? Patna High Court rejected that extra reservation. Yes, Patna High Court. ये लिखवाऊंगा अभी मैं. Okay. Next. So after second backward class commission, 27% reservation was implemented. Okay. That particular case was challenged in Indira Sahani judgment. Indira Sahani case.
Or Indira Sahani judgment.
First,
what Supreme Court said? That 50% limit should not be crossed. First, 50% limit should not be crossed. Second, no reservation in promotion. No reservation in promotion. No reservation in promotion. Okay. Third, 10% reservation for EWS is unconstitutional. 10% reservation for EWS is unconstitutional. Fourth, backward class identified only on the basis of social and educational status. Backward class identified only on the basis of social and educational status. Only on the basis of social and educational status. Okay, now look these five points of Indira Sahani judgment. All the five points are nullified. Now reservation is in promotion. Going on. Yes, 10% reservation for EWS. Yes, 50% limit crossed. Backwardness is identified not only on the basis of economic and okay, other criteria as well. So that entire judgment was nullified by Parliament in its subsequent amendment. Yes or no? Write down. Next thing. Okay, certain constitutional amendment which nullified that judgment particularly. Write down 77th Constitutional Amendment Act. 77th Constitutional Amendment Act that added 16 clause 4A. 16 clause 4A. 16 clause 4A. That is, that allows reservation in promotion. That allows reservation in promotion. So that particular judgment was again nullified. Okay. Second, 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act. 15 clause 6, 16 clause 6. 15 clause 6 in terms of educational institution, in terms of public jobs. Kya hai dono? 10% reservation for EWS. Means that 50% limit is breached. Yes. In this manner, reservation is increasing. Okay, got the idea. Okay, what happened till now? Last, Janhit Abhiyan case. Janhit Abhiyan case. Supreme Court upheld the validity of 10% reservation of EWS. Supreme Court upheld the validity of 10% reservation for 10% reservation for EWS. So reservation in promotion is allowed. That particular Indira Sahani judgment is nullified completely. And now everything is going on. Okay. Now, this is the background that we discussed regarding reservation. There are other cases as well, like M. Nagaraj case. Okay. Was also propounded by judiciary. But that M. Nagaraj case was also diluted by judiciary itself.
in its subsequent judgment. Okay, so there is no need to discuss, okay, in that much detail. Okay, so this is the reservation, okay, in total, in terms of educational institution and in public employment. Now, what is the need to provide reservation? Give some arguments in favor to that. Okay, to uplift those historically deprived classes. Okay, very good. Next. Equal, okay, social justice and equality, okay, because of the historically disadvantageous section, they are historically disadvantageous. Next, adequate representation, okay, that adequate representation means proportional representation or no? That many politicians are saying that reservation should be proportional. Now they are talking about proportional representation. In fact, they are making their speeches in parliament as well. Yes or no? So are we talking about proportional representation or adequate representation? Adequate representation. And what proportional representation means? Okay. In terms of their population, what percent their population count, okay, the same number should reflect in government jobs, educational institution and in parliament. Will it be right or no? Why proportional representation is wrong? Means you are saying that what Rahul Gandhi is demanding is wrong. Yes, jiski jitni abadi uska utna hak. Yes or no? So their population is 1%. So 1%, there is no issue with this. Why it is wrong? My question is, why it is wrong? Everyone will be having their equal representation, okay, with respect to their proportion in the caste, okay, or with respect to their proportion in the total population. Then what is the issue with this particular notion? Yes, tyranny of how it will breach right to equality. Yes or no? It will breach that 50% notion. It will undermine the democracy itself. We are saying that meritocracy has no meaning, okay, if there is no equality. But now you are compromising the entire merit. Yes or no? Now democracy will become mobocracy. You got the idea? Democracy will become mobocracy if we go with this notion. Yes or no? Apart from that, according to this notion, okay, all the seats will be reserved for that particular community. Okay, so are we having homogeneous population in a particular constituency? What about other people who are living in that area? In fact, this issue is still persisting. Like, what about the general category population who are living in STSC reserved seat area? What about them? They can also say that we are not getting representation because they are denied their right to representation in parliament. Getting my point or not? Okay, so it will further, okay, increase that particular discrimination. Yes? Okay, so basically this particular notion will undermine the entire notion of democracy as well as the notion of reservation as well. Okay, because according to, again, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, who wrote this constitution, okay, he said that reservation should limit to the minority seats only, otherwise it will undermine the whole notion of affirmative action. Okay, he made that particular statement in Constituent Assembly, and all the people who are swearing in, okay, by the constitution are not abiding by the same constitution, the same provision, or to the notion or the statement of the same person who wrote that constitution. They are merely raising the slogans, yes or no? Okay, in the name of Dr. Ambedkar, but nobody is following, okay, his ideas. Okay, write down certain arguments in favor of reservation. First point, it is political necessity. It is political necessity. Political necessity for all the sections. It is political necessity for all section should get due representation. All the section should get due representation in the area of policy making. All the section should get due representation in the area of policy making. Due representation. That due representation means adequate representation, but not proportional representation. Second, to correct the historic injustice of thousands of years. Next, to provide level playing field for backward section. Okay, meritocracy is meaningless without equality. Okay, the same argument you can use in polity, the same argument you can use in society section as well. Okay, that is why we are discussing this particular topic in detail. Okay, next. To ensure social justice and social empowerment. To reduce the gap between haves and have-nots. To ensure social justice and social empowerment. Next. Caste system is not merely... Caste occupation link may have been broken for upper caste. But not for the lower segment of society. What this statement means? This is a very nice statement. Okay, in the argument of reservation policy. Okay, other arguments are very generic in nature, social empowerment, equality, but this statement is very powerful. What it means? Caste occupation link may have been broken for upper caste, but not for the lower caste. Matlab? Okay, we can say yes. More? Yes. Very good. Apart from that, anyone? Yes, we will discuss loopholes in this reservation policy. Yes, we will discuss. We are discussing all the things related to reservation. Don't worry. That caste occupation link may have been broken. Means for Brahmins, for Kshatri and for upper caste, that link is broken. Now they are not doing their traditional work. Like Brahmins are not doing their traditional work of being priest, or they are restricted to education. They are doing all sorts of work. But that particular caste occupation link is still there for lower segment of society. Like, who are cleaning those manholes? You got the idea? Who are sweeping the roads? okay, that link is still not broken for the lower caste people. Okay, this statement, it is all about this. Yes, okay, so it is broken for upper caste, but it is still, okay, related to lower caste. They are doing the same polluting task. Okay, nobody from upper caste are doing those tasks. Okay, next. The normal process of development may not automatically close the gap. The normal process of development may not automatically close the gap between dominant and marginalized group. The normal process of development may not close the gap between marginalized and the dominant caste or the dominant groups. Dominant groups. Okay, these are certain arguments with respect to reservation. Now, argument against. You have so many arguments. Now, give all those arguments. Forming of vicious cycle. Like, what is that vicious cycle? Very good. Okay. That elite segment among Dalits, elite segment among ST, okay, has been created. And their generations are getting a reservation. Okay. But the real beneficiaries are not getting a reservation. Okay. We have so many examples in our public life. Okay. We are witnessing that those elite section among Dalits are getting benefits of reservation. Okay. First. Second. More. अभी इतना बोल रहे थे उसके अगेंस्ट में, बताओ ना पॉइंट्स अगेंस्ट द फंडामेंटल राइट. ओके, राइट टू इक्वालिटी, मेरिटोक्रेसी विल बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. कैसे सेम, मेरिटोक्रेसी विल बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. ओके, शी सेड statement. More, it is dividing the society. We brought this particular policy, okay, to end this sort of discrimination and to bring the notion of equality in the society, but this particular policy is aggravating that caste consciousness. Yes or no? Now caste became your identity to get OBC certificates, to get fake OBC certificate. Yes, to get SC certificate and to get fake SC certificates. Yes, so that caste became your identity. Now caste consciousness is further ingrained in your minds. Okay, so it is further aggravating that caste division in the society. Very good point. Next, vote bank politics. Okay, the real issues of public life like unemployment problem, inflation are diverted towards reservation issue. Okay, next, that 50% limit was crossed. Okay, they are in fact violating, okay, the statement of father of the constitution. Yes. Okay, more. Right to equality. Okay, right to equality. Next. And what about the upper caste people who are poor in nature? Their condition is very much bad. Okay. In fact, they are marginalized completely. Why? Because they are not getting any scholarship from the government. They are not getting reservation policy from the government. And they are not getting any other special benefits because they are not in that affirmative action net of the government. Okay. So now they became marginalized. Yes. More. You got the idea? Okay. What are the points? Write down. Same points can be used anywhere you want. In the essay, in the ethics, in society's paper, in polity paper. That is why we are discussing this topic in detail. Okay. First.
it is replacing one type of discrimination with other type of discrimination. One type of discrimination with other type of discrimination. Yes or no? Now, it is the discrimination with the general category students, general category people. That is nothing but compensatory discrimination. Write down. It is replacing one type of discrimination with other type of discrimination. That is compensatory discrimination. That is compensatory discrimination. Second, it is further aggravating caste rigidities and hostilities. Further aggravating caste rigidities and hostilities. How many of you are from Bihar and UP? So you are very well aware of the caste system in these, particularly these two states. Yes or no? Okay. सबको पता और सबका एक्सपीरियंस होना दो अलग अलग बात है. जिन्होंने वहां पे रहे हैं उन्होंने बहुत ज्यादा उसको ढंग से देखा होगा कि ये कास्ट रिजिडिटी कास्ट होस्टिलिटी क्या होती है. नो 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 नहीं 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 नो नो अबे बस 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 बट कास्ट सिस्टम कास्ट होस्टिलिटीज आर वेरी मच इन दीज पर्टिकुलर टू स्टेट्स. यस कास्ट राइट्स ओके यहां पर बहुत ज्यादा है तो ये इसकी वजह से बढ़ रहा है. लड़ना नहीं है आपस में. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट यस नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ पॉपुलेशन बिकॉज ऑफ द कास्ट मूवमेंट इन दीज टू स्टेट्स. लुक एट द पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज रीजनल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज दे these political parties are formed just because of the caste. In fact, we will be discussing that casteization of politics. Prime example is Bahujan Samajwadi Party. That particular party was formed around the caste only. Yes or no? So politicization of caste and casteization of politics, one of the best example. Yes. Earlier, you are invoking that caste identity to get the votes. Now you form the entire party, okay, for one caste only. Yes or no? That is casteization of politics. So, ye dono states jo hai, wo center point rahe hai caste politics ke. Yes? Next. Mismatch hypothesis. Mismatch hypothesis. Everyone in atmosphere in Bihar caste system prevail without caste election is impossible in Bihar. Yes. Okay. Mismatch hypothesis. What is mismatch hypothesis? There is one
very good data
which was stated by Minister of State Education in Lok Sabha last year. What is mismatch hypothesis? Those reserved category students, okay, got admission in IITs, IIMs, and now they are getting drop out. Okay, they are dropping out from those institutions because they are not matching the standards of education in those institutions. That is mismatch hypothesis. Example, Minister of State of Education in Lok Sabha. Minister of State of Education in Lok Sabha said that in the last 5 years 13,600 students from reserved category. 13,600, ye bahut zyada nahi hai. 13,600 students from reserved category dropped out from IITs, IIMs, NITs, etc.
IITs, IIMs, NITs, etc.
That
that is mismatch hypothesis. They are not able to cope up, okay, in those institutions, because other general category students are very, okay, bright in nature. They are very intelligent. Okay, they are getting 99.9 percentile. After that, they are getting admission. And now you are getting less number and getting selected. So you are not able to cope up. Okay, you are not able to compete in those institutions. And you are getting drop out. You got the idea? Next. This is mismatch hypothesis. Next. It is against the essence of meritocracy. It is against the essence of meritocracy. Essence of meritocracy. Or we can say compromising meritocracy. Yes, compromising the merit. Now, next. It became tool to meet narrow political ends. Tool to meet narrow political ends. Example, caste census in Bihar. Narrow political ends. It became tool, okay, to meet narrow political ends. Why? Okay. Yes. Okay, means their population is consistently decreasing in Bihar. Okay. So, Kayasthas are not getting reservation in Bihar. They are from general category. Yes. But just after the caste census data came out, they increased the reservation. So, basically, their ultimate goal to conduct that caste census is to increase reservation. Okay, they did not, okay, bring any of the policy regarding Kayasthas, you are saying. Yes, yes. But we are saying that it became the tool in the hands of politician. Yes. Likho, likho, jaldi yaar, bahut saara likhna hai. Likhiye jaldi. Okay. Okay, so it became the tool in the hands of politicians to meet their narrow political ends. Okay, in fact, you can write down that Karnataka quota, Karnataka bill to have reservation in private sector as well. Next. Benefits of reservation have been appropriated by dominant caste. Benefits of reservation have been appropriated by dominant caste. Appropriated by dominant caste. Dominant caste. Which further aggravated inequality. What is the meaning of dominant caste, anyone? Not upper caste. Upper caste are not getting a reservation. Not lower caste. What is dominant caste? It is a concept. It is a concept, yes. Yes, yes. Dominant caste means that particular caste who are more in numbers, who are having significant vote bank, and because of that number, they included in the OBC list, and now they appropriated all the benefits. Certain caste, which was specifically mentioned by Mandal Commission that these castes should not be included in that OBC list. Yadavs, Jats, Patels. Yes, Mandal Commission ki report public domain mein hai. Aap likh sakte hain. These castes were specifically mentioned by whom? Mandal Commission. That these castes should not be included. These castes are dominant caste. Why? Because of their number. Because of their land holding. Because they are enjoying significant vote bank. Now they used all that vote bank. Yes, they pressurized the politician. And now these all castes included in the OBC list. And they appropriated all the benefits. ये बहुत कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल क्लास है, देखो एग्जाम्पल इसका. एग्जाम्पल 90s, ये वन ऑफ द कमीशन वॉज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय गवर्नमेंट, दैट इज जस्टिस रोहिणी कमीशन फॉर सब कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ द कास्ट. ओके, ये उनकी रिपोर्ट है. राइट डाउन, 97% ऑफ ऑल जॉब्स एंड एजुकेशनल सीट्स, 97% ऑफ ऑल जॉब्स एंड एजुकेशनल सीट्स हैव गॉन टू जस्ट 25% हैव गॉन टू जस्ट 25% 25% ऑफ ऑल सब कास्ट्स क्लासिफाइड इन ओबीसी, all subcasts classified in OBC. Kitna? 97% of the total jobs acquired by only 25% of the caste which are mentioned in OBC. Kaun hogi wo? Dominant caste. Name a few caste? Exactly. Okay. Now, if we are saying that adequate representation, now what about over-representation? We can do something for over-representation also? Yes or no? Because certain castes are over-represented. Because they acquired 97% of the total jobs. What about them? How? एक बार रिजर्वेशन इंक्रीज हुआ तो वो रिड्यूस होता है क्या इंडिया में? ओके, दैट इज व्हाई जस्टिस रोहिणी कमीशन वाज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड. ओके, फॉर सब कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ कास्ट. वो और ज्यादा कॉम्प्लेक्स होगा और कुछ नहीं होगा उससे. देखो नेक्स्ट, द फीलिंग ऑफ रिलेटिव डेप्रिवेशन अमंग फॉरवर्ड क्लास, द फीलिंग ऑफ रिलेटिव डेप्रिवेशन अमंग फॉरवर्ड क्लास. What is the feeling of relative deprivation? Relative deprivation. Among forward class, yeah, forward caste. What is this relative deprivation feeling? Because competition is much more, especially for general category student, seats are very limited. Only 40% seats are open, and in state PSC's exam only 25-30% seats are open. Okay, so there is cutthroat competition. Now general category students are not getting selected. Okay, and the dominant caste that we mentioned, they are getting selected just by having reservation. Still they are not eligible, they are getting fake certificates and they are getting selected. So general category, the feeling of relative deprivation is arisen, okay, among general category student, that we are deprived. Okay, we are deprived from jobs, from scholarships, from our representation, just because of reservation. You got the idea? That is feeling of relative deprivation among general category students. Okay, and the last, poor people from upper caste without any social economic advantage, poor category student or poor class, poor upper caste without any social economical advantage were reduced to being the marginalized section of the society. Marginalized sections of the society. Yes, ये तो अभी आया है. Okay, still they are not getting benefit because of the fake certificate. EWS में भी हो गया भाई, fake certificate बनवा रहे हैं लोग. Like I am working, okay, I am earning more than 8 lakh. Okay, but if I want to have EWS certificate, then I can have that certificate because the basis of that base financial year for this year's certificate will be 2023-24. Okay, but I am earning more than 8 lakh in 2024-25. So I can easily have that EWS certificate. They can be easily managed. They can be easily managed. Trust me. They can be easily managed. Yes? Okay. So still, those people who are not having any reach, especially the general category students, okay, are reduced to the marginalized section of the society. Okay, fake certificates are issued. Okay, kuch nahi lagta yaar, bahut kam paise mein banta hai. Theek hai? Way forward. What is the way forward? What suggestion we can give? What are the appropriate suggestion? Okay, जो examiner को अच्छे लगे. Examiner को अच्छा नहीं लगेगा ये. बताइए. बताइए बताइए जल्दी से. Horizontal and vertical reservation is already there. Horizontal for caste, vertical for woman, horizontal for woman. Horizontal for person with disabilities. Yes, so horizontal reservation is already there. Vertical reservation is already there. Caste reservation is already there. We are providing reservation on the basis of caste. And now class reservation is also there, because EWS section is identified on the basis of class. Yes, so we are having all the four types of reservation. If you want, you can write that we have all the four types of reservation: vertical, horizontal, caste and class. We have all four types of reservation. Vertical, we have vertical reservation. We have horizontal as well. Why? Because women, divyangjan, we are giving reservation to them. Then caste, reservation on the basis of caste, and reservation on the basis of class as well. That is EWS section.
नहीं है, अभी तक नहीं है. आई होप कि आगे भी ना हो.
यस, व्हाट आर द सजेशंस यू कैन गिव? फर्स्ट, अकॉर्डिंग टू सुप्रीम कोर्ट, क्रीमी लेयर शुड बी इंसर्टेड. सुप्रीम कोर्ट नहीं कहा था, क्रीमी लेयर शुड बी इंसर्टेड इन एसटीएससी आल्सो. Yes, to exclude that elite section. That elite section, उस एलिट सेक्शन को सिर्फ एक ही नुकसान होता है कि उनके स्टूडेंट को उठा के ट्रोल किया जाता है ट्विटर पे. यह सुनो, इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं होता है. ओके, सो क्रीमी लेयर शुड बी इंसर्टेड इन एसटीएससी आल्सो. सेकेंड, the concept of de-reservation should be introduced. The concept of de-reservation should be introduced. Concept of de-reservation should be introduced. That is, what is de-reservation? Jinka over-representation hai, identify them and implement de-reservation. Second, जिनकी तीन family को reservation का फायदा मिल गया, उनको बाहर करो. Okay, write down. That is, identify over-represented section. कैसे? ऐसा नहीं है कि उनको job से निकाल रहे हैं, उनको reservation की list से निकाल रहे हैं. आप ज्यादा क्यों सोच रहे हो? रिजर्वेशन की लिस्ट से निकालना जॉब से निकालना नहीं होगा. जॉब उनकी रहेगी, बट देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग्स विल नॉट गेट द बेनिफिट ऑफ रिजर्वेशन. दैट्स इट, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस. अबे गलती क्या है? ये किस टाइप का इमोशनल बिहेवियर है यार? बस हो गया, लिखो भाई, लिखो जल्दी, टाइम नहीं है यार, लिखो फटाफट. Yes, identify overrepresented section and remove those section from the reservation list, whether they are ST, SC, OBC. Like one section from Rajasthan is overrepresentation, overrepresented. Name that caste. Exactly. They are overrepresented. Okay, entire benefit of ST category from Rajasthan is appropriated by that particular section. Yes? You got the idea? So identify them, remove them. That is the concept of de-reservation. Second, third generation of that particular family. ये तो controversial है ना बहुत ज्यादा कि ये किसी की हिम्मत नहीं होगी, ये सिर्फ स्टूडेंट की हिम्मत है कि वो डिस्कस करके लिख लें. थर्ड जनरेशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट. रिजर्वेशन इज नॉट अ पेनेशिया. रिजर्वेशन इज नॉट अ पेनेशिया फॉर ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ लेबर मार्केट. Reservation is not a panacea for all the problems of labor market. Hence, it should be restricted to the private sector only. Yes or no? Because you are solving your unemployment problem with the help of reservation, especially in the private sector. So it is not a panacea. It should be restricted to government sector only. Third, a strong political will is indispensable. Strong political will is indispensable. Okay, to find an equilibrium, that equilibrium got disturbed, okay, in a very bad manner. Yes, find that equilibrium between social justice and right to equality. Right to equality. Okay. There is one statement from Justice Bela Trivedi. Okay. When she was delivering her judgment in Janhit Abhiyan case, she said, write down, at the end of 70 years, this is the best technique, okay, to criticize anyone. Okay. Name some scholars, okay, some judges, okay. So ye aapka criticism nahi hai, ye inka hai. At the end of 70 years of independence, we need to revisit the system of reservation. Revisit the system of reservation in the larger interest of the society. Society as a whole, as a step towards transformative constitutionalism. Okay, as a step towards transformative constitutionalism. Okay, so Justice Bela Trivedi also said that, okay, there is a time, okay, when we should revisit that particular system. Okay, she is also suggesting that that system needs overhauling. Yes or no? Okay, next. Another judge in that same case said that a reservation is not an end. rather a means to secure socio-economic justice. You should use these courts, okay? है ना, ये जजेस के कोर्ट्स हैं और बहुत है ना एक अथॉरिटी दे करके आएंगे आंसर में. अ रिजर्वेशन इज नॉट एन एंड, रादर अ मींस टू अचीव सोशियो इकोनॉमिक जस्टिस. इट शुड नॉट कंटिन्यू फॉर इनडेफिनेट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. So as to become vested interest. Yes. So it should not be continued for indefinite time. And now, for because of that indefinite time, now it became vested interest or not? Yes, it became vested interest in the hands of politicians. Okay. Third, and one of the most important statement for reservation, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. Okay. To safeguard the principle of equality of opportunity, reservation should always be confined. To minority of the seats. To safeguard the principle of equality of opportunity, reservation should always be confined to minority of the seats. Reservation should be confined to the minority of the seats. Minority of the seats means it should not cross that 50% limit. Yes or no? Because reservation is nothing but an exception. Yes or no? It is exception to merit, exception to competition. Okay. That exception cannot be greater than norm. Yes or no? What is the norm? Merit, open competition. So merit should always remain greater, which means jo norm jo hai, jo merit jo hai, unki jo seate hai, wo hamesha 50% se zyada honi chahiye. Okay, that was the statement made by Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar himself, jinhone constitution likha hai. And look at what our politicians are saying. One politician, okay, wo pichle ek saal se ek hi baat bol rahe hain, that when we come into power, then we will remove that 50% limit. Yes, and now he was also saying that, okay, hum samvidhan ko bachayenge. How? Whatever the statements you are making are contradictory in nature. Okay, because you are not following the mandate of the father of constitution himself. Okay, next, Patna High Court, recent judgment of Patna High Court. Why Patna High Court gave this judgment recently? Because of that increased reservation after caste census in Bihar. Okay, so Patna High Court said, first, ये उन पॉलिटिशियंस को पढ़ना चाहिए डिटेल में, और यदि उनको समझ में नहीं आ रहा हो तो आपके कोई पहचान वाले हो तो समझाओ उनको कि सर ये ऐसा है. एडिक्वेट रिप्रेजेंटेशन डज नॉट मीन प्रोपोर्शनेट रिप्रेजेंटेशन. ठीक है. Now we are not saying, Patna High Court is saying the same thing, that adequate representation does not mean proportionate representation. Second, backward caste are already occupying 69% of the total jobs in Bihar. Hence, they are adequately represented. अच्छा ये 69% में से भी कौन सी कास्ट होगी जो ओवर रिप्रेजेंटेड होगी, आप जानते हैं, ठीक है, बट नोबडी विल से एनीथिंग, व्हाई, बिकॉज ऑफ द वोट बैंक, सिंपल, यस, सो दे आर एडिक्वेटली रिप्रेजेंटेड. थर्ड, 50% लिमिट शुड नॉट बी क्रॉस्ड. 50% लिमिट शुड नॉट बी क्रॉस्ड. Merit, next, merit cannot be compromised in the garb of social justice schemes. Merit cannot be compromised in the garb of social justice scheme. और जो हमने suggestion दिया था, concept of de-reservation, okay, which made you emotional, okay, तो पटना हाई कोर्ट ने भी कहा है उस पे, अरे नहीं 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 ऐसा नहीं है, अरे मेरा भी नहीं है, मैं भी तो हंसी रहा हूं, ठीक है. सो द सेम स्टेटमेंट वॉज मेड बाय पटना हाईकोर्ट एज वेल. पटना हाईकोर्ट सेड दैट देयर इज अ नीड टू सब कैटेगराइजेशन, देयर इज अ नीड टू सब कैटेगराइज, देयर इज अ नीड टू सब कैटेगराइज द एग्जिस्टिंग रिजर्वेशन, subcategorize the existing reservation and exclude the caste, and exclude the caste, exclude the caste which are already adequately represented, which are already adequately represented. Okay, you got the idea? This is all about reservation. Okay, some of our prime ministers also made certain statement regarding reservation. Write those down also. Okay, जब बहुत ज़्यादा criticism एकदम question की tone ही वैसी हो कि आपको सिर्फ criticize करना है, तो आप लिखिएगा पंडित नेहरू. पूछा हुआ है और पूछा जाएगा. In any of the, देखो ethics में आ सकता है, okay? Same data है, आपको वहाँ पर modify करके लिखना है. Ethics में paper one society and paper two polity, तीन जगह पूछा जा सकता है same question, ठीक है? इसीलिए हमने इतने सारे courts से इतना सारा data लिख लिया ताकि आपको रहे. अभी हमें comparison और देखना है. अभी अपने पास 15 मिनट है. हम reservation policy ऐसी ही affirmative action policy also implemented by in the United States as well, okay, but US discontinued that policy, okay, so we will also make comparison, okay, yes yeah, wo aaj ka topic nahi hai, wo hai na, wo fir civil services reform wala topic hai. Ek do din jab next class mein kabhi hum usko uthayenge aur usko bhi discuss kar lenge, aise hi wo news mein aane do, hai na, इस सेंस में आएगा न्यूज में तो हम उसको उठा लेंगे एक बार. देखिए पंडित नेहरू, दैट इज रिजर्वेशन मेक द कंट्री सेकंड, वेट, रिजर्वेशन विल मेक द कंट्री सेकंड वेट ऑफ सेकंड ग्रेड. मिस्टर राजीव गांधी, उन्होंने भी एक स्टेटमेंट कहा था और उनके सुपुत्र को चोर भी बोलते हैं, ठीक है. ओबीसी रिजर्वेशन इज एन अटेम्प्ट टू डिवाइड द कंट्री ऑन कास्ट लाइंस. ओबीसी रिजर्वेशन इज एन अटेम्प्ट टू डिवाइड द कंट्री ऑन द कास्ट लाइंस. इंटरेस्टिंगली दिस स्टेटमेंट वॉज मेड बाय मिस्टर राजीव गांधी इन द पार्लियामेंट व्हेन मंडल कमीशन रिपोर्ट वॉज डिस्कस्ड. Okay, that statement was made by Rajiv Gandhi in the parliament that OBC reservation is an attempt to divide the country on the caste lines. अरे तो opposition में तो आपका stand इतना radically change थोड़ी ना होगा. Opinion तो opinion रहता है ना, कि इंसान power के लिए कुछ भी कर सकता है. अब ये तो होता ही है, लेकिन ठीक है. Now, it is clear. रिसेंटली एक दूसरी न्यूज भी हम कर देते हैं कवर, दैट रिसेंटली कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट, रिसेंटली कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट पास्ट, रिसेंटली कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट पास्ट अ बिल, which mandate reservation for locals in private sector, that is 75%, that is 75% for non-management position, 75% for non-management position and 50% for management position, 50% for management position, 50% for management position. Okay, earlier the same attempts were made by Madhya Pradesh, Haryana and Jharkhand. Yes or no? ये मध्य प्रदेश में भी हुआ था, मध्य प्रदेश हरियाणा एंड झारखंड. ओके, नाउ गिव सम आर्ग्यूमेंट्स इन फेवर ऑफ दिस, गिव सम आर्ग्यूमेंट्स, कैन वी सपोर्ट. Okay, locals are not getting adequate jobs because of the outsiders. Okay, so rather than training them, we should provide them reservation and it will solve all the problems. Main to abhi support mein baat ho rahi. Yes. How? And we are saying that Bangalore is the Silicon Valley of India and Silicon Valley will work efficiently, okay, by looking at apno ko. Aisa hai kya? Nahi yaar. What are the arguments that we can give in this favor of private sector reservation? I don't think any argument can will be suffice. लिख लो फिर भी. इकोनॉमिक इक्विटी एंड बैलेंस्ड रीजनल ग्रोथ. ऑल्दो बैलेंस्ड रीजनल ग्रोथ, कर्नाटक इज ऑलरेडी ओके हेविली इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड, फिर भी कहां से होगा यार. एक ही है बस, कल्चरल प्रिजर्वेशन है. लिख लो कल्चरल प्रिजर्वेशन. बैलेंस्ड रीजनल ग्रोथ तो नहीं है, बिहार कहे तो समझ में भी आता है, कर्नाटक में थोड़ी आएगा. यस और नो? तो आए ना ऐसा तो लिखना, देयर इज नो आर्ग्यूमेंट इन सपोर्ट ऑफ दैट. ओके, व्हाट आर द अगेंस्ट? ओके, अगेंस्ट द फंडामेंटल राइट, यू कैन नॉट इम्पोज रिजर्वेशन पॉलिसी इन द प्राइवेट सेक्टर. 50% तो लिमिट है ही. मोर discrimination, okay, it will further leads to the okay regional consciousness, okay, it will further aggravate the situation of regionalism. Yes to yes, linguistic regionalism which is already very much prevalent in Karnataka. Yes, that Kannadiga pride issue. Okay, so it will further aggravate the same thing. Are bus very good, very good, good point. Yes, constitutional morality is violated. Very good. Next. Huh? Hatred. Yes, wohi regionalism. Acute sense of regionalism will be promoted. Write down. It will promote linguistic regionalism. Yes, linguistic regionalism. Second, aggravate the social tension between locals and outsiders. That is son of soil concept. Yes? Son of soil concept. Next. Violation of principle of equality and constitutional morality. Yes, next. It will impact business competitiveness. And deter domestic and international investors. And last, constitutional and legal challenge. That is Punjab and Haryana High Court already. Punjab and Haryana High Court already declared such law of Haryana government unconstitutional. Next point. Supreme Court in Dr. Pradeep Jain case. Okay. A candidate cannot be excluded on the domicile criteria. Okay, so these are legal challenges. Supreme Court and High Courts already declared that you cannot implement private quota in the private sector. Okay, you got the idea. Apart from that, we have discussed educational reservation in educational institution, reservation in government jobs. Now last, political representation. Write down certain provisions regarding political representation. Kya kya hai? Political representation se related provisions. Huh? Article 330 and Article 332. D for Panchayati Raj Institution. ST and SC. For municipalities, ST and SC, according to the proportion of their population. 330 in Lok Sabha, SC and ST, according to proportion of their population. And Legislative Assembly, SC and ST, according to proportion in the population. Yes, these provisions are related to political representation. Yes. Then 106th Constitutional Amendment Act 2023 or 2024 में आया था ये नारी वंदन अधिनियम. ये अभी इसी साल का है ना.
ये लास्ट ईयर आया था, 23 में आया था शायद, है ना,
106th कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट
203.
सो आर्टिकल 330A विल बी एडेड, दैट विल प्रोवाइड 1/3 ऑफ द टोटल सीट्स फॉर वुमेन इन लोकसभा, एंड 332A विल बी एडेड फॉर लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली 1/3 सीट्स फॉर द वुमेन. दैट इज नारी शक्ति वंदन अधि नियम,
नारी शक्ति वंदन अधिनियम. थ्री थर्टी ए, 332 एंड 239AA.
239 आर्टिकल 239AA इज रिलेटेड टू दिल्ली असेंबली. दिल्ली
This is the example of that horizontal reservation जो आप बोल रहे थे ना, horizontal, वो ये horizontal reservation का example है, ठीक है?
1/3 seats for women. What are other provisions of this particular act apart from these five, one, two and three provisions?
Those 1/3 seats will be rotated after every election.
रोटेशन मतलब क्या होता है? लाइक फॉर एसटी एंड एससी सीट्स आर फिक्स्ड, ओके, बट वुमन रिजर्व सीट्स विल बी रोटेटेड, ओके. हाँ, यस यस, लाइक पंचायती राज इंस्टीट्यूशन सीट्स आर रोटेटिंग, ओके, फॉर वुमन स्पेशली. अदरवाइज सीट्स आर फिक्स्ड.
So, लिख लो 1/3 seats, rotation of the seats. Second provision is rotation of the seats. Rotation of the seats to different constituency. Rotation of the seats to different constituency. Okay, after every year, that seat will be rotated. Okay? And third, the act shall remain in force. The act shall remain in force till 15 years of the commencement. The act shall remain in force till the 15 years of the commencement. Okay?
जब इसकी 15 साल है तो बाकियों की 70 साल से क्यों चल रही है? Yes, the question is this. Because of politics.
Okay. What are the advantage of this woman's reservation bill?
In last Lok Sabha, only 14% woman, okay, got elected. That is 78. Out of 545 MPs of Lok Sabha. Okay. So, women are not adequately represented. That is why 1/3 reservation is given. Second, why adequate representation is necessary? Why? Reason.
Women's participation in politics, or very good, formation of policies and schemes from women's perspective. Okay, participation of women, especially adequate participation of women in legislature, will bring diverse perspective or women's perspective in that particular policy program, or okay, in any of the legislation. Very good.
More. और क्या होगा? Look, this particular act will be implemented after next delimitation, that is pending on 2026. Okay? और क्या होगा? ये क्वेश्चन यूपीएससी प्री ने पूछा था इस बार, अभी 24 में आ चुका है ये पूरा। पहला ही स्टेटमेंट था कि दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्ट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स, नहीं आफ्टर 2026 इंप्लीमेंट हुआ। यस एक देयर इज अ फिनोमेना इन पंचायती राज इंस्टीट्यूशन और इन म्युनिसिपैलिटी दैट इज प्रधानपति, दैट इज प्रधानपति। ओके, व्हाट इफ द सेम फिनोमेना ओके विल बी रेप्लिकेटेड इन दीज सीट्स, देयर आर चांसेस और नॉट, देयर आर चांसेस। ओके, सो दिस इज द नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट ऑल्सो। ओके, दैट बा बहु क्या था वो, बहन बहु और बेटी, यस ओके, दोस ट्रिपल बी विल गॉट रिप्रेजेंटेड। ओके, जो ऑलरेडी एस्टेब्लिश्ड पॉलिटिशियन है उन्हीं के दीस ट्रिपल बी, दैट इज सिस्टर वाइफ एंड मदर डॉटर, ओके, दे विल गेट रिप्रेजेंटेड। तो दीज आर सर्टेन नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट, voters will be having less choice. Yes, what about voters choice if they okay they are not agreeing with those candidates but that particular seat is reserved for women? Yes, so less choice for voters, discrimination against men. What about those male candidates? Why 1/3 seats are reserved? Okay, now they cannot contest election from that particular seat. So it is discriminatory towards the man also. हम negative में भी बोल रहे हैं ना, अभी positive बोल दिया हमने, तो अब negative ये है उसका। How? अरे तो no, अरे बस लड़ना नहीं है, अरे लड़ना नहीं है ऐसे। बट दीज आर द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स, ये मेरे पॉइंट्स नहीं है, दीज आर द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स गिवन बाय द सम क्रिटिक्स, ओके, गिवन बाय सम क्रिटिक्स दैट इट विल बी डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी। दिस इज द सेम आर्ग्यूमेंट दैट जनरल कैटेगरी स्टूडेंट्स आर गिविंग फॉर रिजर्वेशन इन पब्लिक जॉब्स एंड इन अदर ओके अदर टाइप्स ऑफ रिजर्वेशन, दैट इट इज डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी टूवर्ड्स जनरल कैटेगरी स्टूडेंट। So the same arguments are given by those male candidates for women reservation. Simple hai. Okay. Ye kuch 5-6 arguments hai regarding, okay, that will be provided in that handout. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. Ruk jao. Okay. So we will continue our current affairs classes in this manner. जो भी उस हफ्ते में न्यूज में होगा, जो टॉपिक बहुत ज्यादा न्यूज में रहा होगा, ओके, वी विल नॉट गोइंग टू कवर दोस फैक्चुअल थिंग्स, ओके, वी विल पिक सर्टेन इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स एंड वी विल डिस्कस दोस 2-3 टॉपिक्स इन डिटेल, ओके, इज दिस ओके फॉर यू? या वो फैक्चुअल वाले पे जाए कि मैं फैक्ट बताऊं और आप उसको लिखते जाओ बैठते जाओ? नो, ओके, so we will continue our current affairs classes in this manner. Okay, thank you.